This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, we're still working with equations that have fractions, and we're getting to the more complicated examples here. This is one where we've got fractions, but we also have parentheses with a distributive property. And we can either multiply by the least common denominator first, simplify it, and then do the distributive property, or we could do the distributive property first and then multiply by the least common denominator. I'm going to suggest you do the distributive property first. Usually that causes less complications for students. So that's how I'm going to work this problem. So we only have one distributive property right here, right? So we've got 3/4 times 2x minus 3/4 times 1. And over here we just have 5/2 x plus 3. So you could reduce this 2 and 4, but I see that I've got a 4 as a denominator over here anyway, so I'm just going to leave it as 4. So I'm going to write this as 6x over 4 minus 3/4 equals 5/2 x plus 3. You could have written this as 3/2, that's fine. All right, so what's the least common denominator now? Got 4 and a 4 and a 2. So 4 is the least common denominator. So we're going to multiply everything by 4, both sides of the equation, each term. So we have 4 times 6x over 4 minus 4 times 3/4, 4 times 5/2 x, and 4 times 3. All right, and this is why I left this as 6x over 4. It's really easy to cancel. But if you had written, just keep in mind, if you had written this as 4 times 3x over 2, you're going to get the same thing. After canceling, you're going to get 6x, which is what I'm going to get when I cancel it here. I'm going to get 6x for the first term. So we have 6x minus, those 4s cancel completely, so I'm going to have minus 3. The 2 goes into the 4 twice, so I have 2 times 5 times x, that's 10x. And I just have 4 times 3, which is 12. Just going to change this to a green, like everything else. All right, so we have 6x minus 3 equals 10x plus 12. And now we need to simplify this. I'm sorry, we need to solve this by getting the variables on one side and constants on the other. So we did the distributive property first. We multiply by the least common denominator. And then we get a nice equation without any fractions or parentheses. You could put the variables on the left or the right-hand side. I'm going to go ahead and put it on the left-hand side. So I'm going to subtract 10x from both sides. And that will give me a negative 4x when I add these. So I also want to get rid of this minus 3 by adding 3 to both sides. So that's going to be 15. Last step will be to divide by 4, I'm sorry, negative 4. So x equals negative 15/4. Okay, so that was a long problem. It probably takes most of a page, unless you write really tiny. And you could do this another way, but I'm going to suggest strongly that you go ahead and just do it by doing the distributive property first. I think it is a little bit easier to follow. So let's go ahead and check our answer to see if negative 15/4 is the right answer. So we're going to plug in negative 15 force for x, and we're going to do our order of operations. That's what you do when you check it. I need a little extra space here. So we have 3 force to do all this. We have 2, I'm going to write that as 2 over 1, times this negative 15 force. Minus 1. All right, so we need to simplify this. So I can cancel the 2 and the 4 to get it down to that. Makes it a little bit easier, smaller numbers. So we have 3 fourths times, what do I have here? I've got the minus sign, so I got negative 15 halves. I'm going to write that as negative 15 over 2 minus 1. Now, let's write that with a common denominator of 2. So 1 can be written as 2 over 2. So now I could simplify inside the parentheses, 3 fourths times negative 15. Remember, minus 2 means plus a negative 2, so that's negative 17. And what do you do with the denominators? It still halves. Don't add those 2s or multiply those 2s. Now we're multiplying 3 fourths times negative 17 halves. So 3 times negative 17 is a negative number, negative 51. And 4 times 2 is 8. So the left-hand side simplified to negative 51 eighths. All right, we're going to put in negative 15 fourths on the other side for x. Negative 15 fourths plus 3. So nothing cancels here when I do the multiplication. I get negative 75 eighths plus 3. All right, so we need to get a common denominator. We need to make this eighths, right? So we could do that by multiplying 3 over 1 times 8 over 8, which is going to be 24. All right, now we've got a common denominator of 8, so it's going to be eighths. And negative 75 plus 24 is going to be negative, and then we subtract 75 minus 24 to get negative 51, and then we compare. Yay, it was the right answer. So, we did get the correct solution. It was negative 15 fourths. So we can write that was the right answer. And of course, you could write that as a decimal or a fraction. And if you use the solution set notation, we'd write negative 15 fourths. So we've done a lot of problems solving equations with fractions, from the very simple ones, like 1 half x equals 3, all the way to a more complicated problem like this, where we've got both fractions and parentheses, etc. So just keep practicing. Using the idea of multiplying both sides by the least common denominator really makes it easier, especially when you have more than one term on each side. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.